In today's lesson, you'll learn how can you determine if three sides with given lengths form a triangle, like 6, 8, and 10. Well, that definitely makes a triangle, looks like that. But what about 6, 8, 12? Well, with that longer third side, the 6 and the 8 have to form a wider angle to make that a triangle. So what about a 6, 8, 5 triangle? Well, the 6 and the 8 would go there, and they would form an acute angle, kind of fold over that way. And then the other side with the 5 goes right there. These three will definitely make a triangle. So let's go ahead and put these three up here and look at them in a little bit later. So let's look at some other examples. What about 6, 8, 20? The 6 and the 8 can go there, and the 20 is going to be very long. It's going to be too long. Even if the 6 and the 8 were to widen out like that and get an obtuse angle, they're never going to reach the 20. So the 6 and the 8 together are still less than the 20. That's why it won't work. 6 plus 8 is going to be less than that. So let's keep that in mind. What about 6, 8, and 14? The 6 and the 8 together equal 14. Now the 14 is still going to be very long, but what if it's exactly 14? Well, let's go ahead and wind that out to a straight line to make it exactly 14. That doesn't make a triangle. The reason why this doesn't work is because it's equal to that third side. So the 6 plus the 8 is equal to 14. That's why it doesn't work. So what we've learned so far is that the 6 plus the 8 must be greater than the third side. 6 plus 8 is 14. That doesn't work here. It's not greater than 20. The 6 plus 8 is not greater than 14. But let's look at the ones we know that work. 14. Yes, 14 is greater than the 10. 14 is greater than 12. 14 is greater than 5. But let's try another one that's not going to work. See what else we can learn. What if we make it really short, the third side? Let's see. 6, 8, 1. Well, we still have our 6 and our 8, and that 1 is really tiny over there. Even if I take this 6 and fold it over, make an acute angle, let's just redraw the 6 right there. You can see that it's not going to reach far enough to make a triangle. This 1 is less than that difference between the 6 and the 8. It'd have to stretch 2 more to reach all the way to make the 8. So 1 is less than that. So the third side must be greater than the difference of the two other sides. And we can see that that is true for the ones that work. 10 is greater than 2, 12 is greater than the 2, and the 5 is greater than 2. That's why that little one works. Now here's the really cool part. We can put these two ideas together into one inequality. Let's see if I can line up that C. And there we go. The C has to be in between the sum and the difference of the two other sides. That's the big idea of this entire tutorial. Let's go ahead and put that together and write it up here. So here's the big idea. For any three lengths to form a triangle, the third length must be between the sum and the difference of the other two. Let's go ahead and work out a couple of examples. I've got a 5, 12, 13, and 2, 4, 7. And I'm going to randomly pick 13 to be the C, the third side. And let's go ahead and put it in between the sum, 5 plus 12, and the difference, I'm going to go ahead and flip them around. I don't need any negative numbers here. 12 minus 5, 7. So 13, is that between 17 and 7? Yes, it is. So it works. Well, let's try 2, 4, and 7. I'm going to randomly choose the 7 to be the third side. 7, is that in between 4 plus 2, and 4 minus 2. Let's see. 4 plus 2 is 6. 4 minus 2 is 2. Is 7 in between those two? No, it's not in between those two. Let's try this again, but here I'm going to randomly choose another side, and it's still going to come out the same way. It doesn't matter what you pick. So, C is 12. Is that in between 5 plus 13 and the 13 minus the 5? We have 18, and 13 minus 5 is 8. Is 12 in between? Yes, it still works. It's always going to work. Well, if I put 4 in between, let's do 7 plus 2 and 7 minus 2. Is 4 going to be in between those two? Let me see. I got a 9. And 7 minus 2 is 5. Is 4 in between? No. It doesn't matter which one you pick. Just remember, in order to form a triangle, the third side must be in between the sum and the difference of the other two sides. That's the big idea today.